If you'd like to build an oscilloscope for cheap, like 20 bucks, I'll show you how. I call this thing the Cheaposcope. It does a pretty good job at measuring square waves from my Arduino, or sine waves like me grabbing the electrical cord to my laptop, or me grabbing the transformer to my laptop. Of course, these are insulated, so I'm not getting shocked. Building this is pretty simple. You need a good fast display, an Uno, some wire, and a pot if you want to play with the PMW signals. Hook ground to ground, VCC to 5 volts, SCL to the analog A5, and SDA to A4, and that's all you need to hook up your display. Of course, you'll need a wired hook to your input measurement probe. Just like that, with my code, you've got an oscilloscope. I'm going to add a little bit of color here. I'm going to add a pot between the ground and the VCC, and the output to pin A1 so I can control the width of my pulse width modulation. And just like that, I can vary the amount of PWM from 0 volts all the way up to plus 5 volts, and you can see that change on the screen. Kind of fun to play around with. If you're wondering what the accuracy is, this is actually a 488 signal coming in for or coming out of my Arduino, and I'm getting pretty close with 495 or 460 or so hertz. This signal here, around 247, is what I'm measuring with my Cheaposcope, and the Arduino is putting out around 240 or so. I don't remember the exact value. Down to 120, it still does a pretty good job getting the accuracy of the actual hertz right, and you can see the actual fluctuation at the plus 5 volt level. Code is pretty simple. I will give this to you for free. In the comment block, I've given you all the information, like links to the display that I'm using, links to the libraries I'm using, and the pin connection location callouts, but that's a pretty simple process. Of course, like anything, you'll need to include the right header file and set your pin information. Just a couple lines of code to activate your display with the simple begin call. Now, you don't need to do this, but I am actually using PWM for my demo here, and I've given you all the constants to vary your PWM frequencies from the maximum to the minimum. Just uncomment whatever speed that you want, and make sure you have your pin connected to the right port. The only real pin mode that you need is the read pin. The other two are just for my demo for measuring the PWM so you can see the neat signal that we're measuring. And of course, we're using the analog write on the PWM to get the output square wave. One thing I found was neat with my program here is I'm actually calculating the initial rise time of the signal, measuring the start time, and then measuring the rise time again of that same signal to get the final end time. I'm using some simple calculations here to subtract the two to figure out what the total distance between that wave is. And this becomes eventually becomes my hertz. Two simple lines is all it takes to measure all of the data for your display. Two simple lines to display all of that data to the screen. The rest of this code draws a cute little graph on the screen, prints the Cheaposcope text, and shows the value in hertz. This is, of course, optional, and if your display doesn't fit this header information, you can, of course, get rid of it. This is the important part here. If your display doesn't have enough memory to build your display in memory, you won't be able to pop it to the screen with one clock, one line of code. So make sure your display has this capability. If you're wondering what the accuracy is, down to 30 hertz, this thing gets a little bit tired. It doesn't seem to work very well, although it's tracking the signal fairly well, but above about 3,000 or so, it doesn't work very well. And I'm trying to measure 3,900 hertz. But right around 1,000, it seems to do a pretty good job measuring this square wave. But as you saw previously, you can also measure sine waves and some other funky waves. Well, I just saved you a ton of money, and I think that's worth a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.